Vasile's milkshake brings all the vatos to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours, darn right, it's better than yours. He could teach you, but he'd have to charge.
Yo, 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 what's up, YouTubers? What y'all doing? What y'all tripping about up in here? We got Speedy Gonzalez up in here. Anybody wants to buy a J series, hit me up. That was my wife, 08 Acura TS Type S. Yeah, what's going on today, guys? What's the story, huh? Okay. Just want to show you my new addition, which some of you guys may know. I used to own a bike like this, KTM 1290 Super Duke R. And I just had to do it again. I regret selling it, my old one. I found a deal on this one in California. It only has 700 miles. Let me show you right here. 765 miles. It's a beast. You want to hear what it sounds like? If it starts. So that's kind of what I've been up to lately. I picked up two set of wheels. Picked up this C28, kind of green. And those Z40s, Volk 17s. So, the story is this. And I'll let you hear it. For the camera. You see that right there? Watch. Yeah, we have a bad wheel bearing. Not happy about this. So we're gonna have to take the wheel off, take the caliper off, take the chingaleta steering auto tie rod right there, unbolt the bottom bar joint, unbolt the top bar joint, loosen the brake line, and you have a spindle in your hand. And what we're going to do, we're gonna move this Acura TX6 wheels, it's my wife's wheels, and we're gonna go ahead and set it up right here, and I'll show you guys how we're going to do this. Tip can, it's supposed to be a national bearing, I didn't even open it, let's see. Hopefully that's what it is. That's what a bearing looks like. Made in Japan, huh? Koyo. Supposed to be like good bearings. Anyways, so this is the bearing. We're gonna go ahead and just install this bad boy up in here. We can't be having that when we go baseball, right, Della?
Right.
And where's your shoes? Where's your shoes? Go get your shoes on.
No. Oh, fine.
So, yeah. Just gonna go ahead and just get cracking on this car here in a bit. Got my tools right there. Got my air compressor. I'm just gonna pull that hose down. Whew, I can't wait to go beast mode. And not just that. I picked up a set of wheels. That's for backup. So when I wear out those tires, bam, I already have a set of tires ready to go. The sucky thing about this bike is, it eats up tires like you won't believe it. The torque that this bike makes, oh boy, it's phenomenal. I mean, it's phenomenal. Anyways, let's leave the bike, the wagon, and let's get to it.
Guys, we're back. on another video of the Silly Garage.
Uh-huh.
Are we changing the wheel bearings?
Changing the wheel bearing, yeah.
So first we have to take off the wheel.
Uh-huh.
Right, Daddy?
Yeah.
Look at that. Oh, that looks
You have to take the brakes.
The brakes back there?
Yeah. I have to take the spindle right here on top.
On top? Okay.
The one at the bottom.
The one on the, oh yeah, there's
the one right here on the side.
Oh, there's so much of them.
The brake right here.
I don't think I can reach it.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
Can you even see?
Yeah, of course. And then bearings inside here.
Bearings inside there.
We're going to have to take that nut right there.
Where? So we're going to have to take this off?
Take that nut, yeah. Watch your feet.
Huh. So first we have to go to here and get some tools, right, Daddy?
Oh, of course, dude. We gotta get this big sucker right here, 36
Ooh,
millimeters.
That's big. Oh, that's really loud.
Beast ball right here.
Oh, look. Screen off. Took that off. As you can tell, we just set it that down right there.
Just letting this off.
Oh, now we're hiring it. Racing it. Yeah. Love you, Dad.
Huh?
Love you.
Love you too, sister.
So, now we're going to, what are we going to do now?
We're going to take this pin right here at the top.
The pin on the top? I don't think I can reach it. I'm going to go ahead and be right back and get a chair. Okay. I need a chair because I'm too tall. Tiny. I'm the tiniest of my family. Round and the Okay.
Yeah, there's pins. There's pins everywhere, see that?
Yeah. Okay. We're taking this off.
Okay.
Show them what we're taking off right now. We're taking off these things. We're taking off that thing. That thing right there. Oi! My dad's getting in the moves.
Show me your jam. Show me your jam.
I don't like doing it.
Show them your jam.
I'm scared. I'm shy.
Show me your jam. Trust me, she likes to jam, but on camera she's being shy right now. I don't know why.
I don't like doing it on camera.
You don't like doing it on camera?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, okay. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and get to it right here and remove this stuff up.
Okay.
See anything still here?
Oh, get that. Get the people. You get it off?
Right
yep,
up.
We got it off. It's right there in my dad's hands. I need to jump off the stool to get it.
See it?
Okay. I'll show you guys from here.
Right there,
whoopsies. Sorry. I'm not that good with a camera.
Yeah, you're definitely horrible with the camera right now.
You
got that white shirt super dirty right now.
Nah.
I bet those people watching it be like, wow, dude, they're like so dirty right now. What's going on?
Dad, he's being mean.
See, I got the moves, dude.
See, you got the moves.
I got the moves,
so you
dude.
Just set those down because you just put them out. It's an asshole. I'm gonna move the chair.
I got the
moves,
bro.
Got the moves!
I got the moves, bro.
Did I recording this?
I think the spindle off right here.
Okay.
Yeah.
We took that off, did we?
Uh-huh. Then we got another one.
Whoa.
Oops.
I'm not that good on this chair.
Yeah, well, hold on to something so you don't fall. See, you got it over here, see?
Right back Can we get off?
Gotta take all the lines. We gotta take the lines out. We gotta take the caliper off. Yep.
Yep.
Take the caliper next, right here.
May I hold my hand? Hold my hand. Daddy, hold my hand.
Huh?
I'm scared. Hold.
Okay, let's get down then. Okay. You don't get scared.
Whee!
Alright. Well,
I'll do it from over here.
Let's come back to that. We're just gonna go ahead and close right now because we're gonna take the calipers and everything off.
Yep. And I don't want to get hurt, right?
You definitely don't want to get hurt, yeah.
Because I might crack my head open. Plus, this floor is solid.
Yeah, you don't want to crack your head
open. Yeah. My dad's friend's daughter, she accidentally cracked her head open because she accidentally fell down the stairs. Right, Dad?
Yep, that is true.
So we're going to end the video right now. Right, Daddy?
Yeah, sounds good. We'll come back. Okay. Once we get the speed door off.
Yeah. We'll come back soon. But don't forget, you're awesome.
Can you feel that? The plate right there, pretty bad. So you loosen this one up right here. This is the top one, right, competing right here. And yeah, just bust it out, pop the chigaleta. I'll show you guys the next step. There's your spindle. So what you gotta do, you gotta pop this right here. You gotta pop that down. That's the hub. You're gonna reuse the hub. And the bearing is inside. Once you pop the hub, it's got a safety ring. I'll show you in a second. So first of all, we gotta do, we gotta pop this out right here. That's your 36 millimeter hub, which it was like that. What I did, I beat it right there, and it came off. Now the one thing that's kind of tricky about this little chase right here, you see that? You have to cut it with a grinder, kind of an angle, and then hit it with a chisel, and it will snap, and you'll be able to pull it off, because you cannot take this one off. Some people like to heat it up and then pull it out, but you gotta take that off. That's a chase of the other half that's inside the spindle, which looks just like that one. So, as you can tell, we got a C-clamp here. We're gonna go ahead and remove that C-clamp, and just knock that bearing out from the back. And I got this press right here. And then we're gonna concentrate on cutting this one out, and I'll show you in a second. I got the spindle and this chingaleta right here. It's called the press. This is a Harbor Free 20 ton, you know what I'm saying? And you can tell it's kind of in between on both sides. Got a 38 millimeter socket right there. And I'm just gonna go ahead and crank it down. And that should get it, hopefully. See how it's going down, right? Because once it falls down, oh, there you have it. So that's the old bearing. That's kind of how it looks. Now what we gotta do, sometimes you might be able to hit it with a chisel right here and it'll snap, shattered. But most cases you have to just cut it right there with the chisel, with the grinder. And I'll show you in a second. Let me get it set up. So you got your dribble. It's got a small wheel. And in fact, you can tell the difference between the big wheel and the small wheel, right? The reason why I'm using the small wheel, because you're trying to get to the as closest to the edge right there. So if you're using a big wheel, guess what? The big wheel is gonna set you back a little bit, and otherwise you're gonna cut into that, and you don't want to cut into that. So the smaller wheel actually works really good on there, you know. You see what I'm talking about? That way it doesn't hit the top. Now, from my experiences, the way I have it cut right now, I can easily just hit it right there with a chisel, and this will crack. Watch. see if you can. I don't know how to set the camera so you can see the process, but I'm trying to set this camera so you can sort of see. Hold on. Maybe when I hit it, the vibration is gonna make the camera fall. So what you do is you put this in the crack there. Let it hit it. Hopefully the GoPro doesn't fall down either. Of course it did. So hey guys, let me give it a good wax. You see that? Easy. That's it. You can see, you can tell the crack right there. You can tell the crack right there. The split. You can probably see it through there. See that, the split? And that's easy to pop it out. There you go. That's all it takes. This is a 36 millimeter carceps hub, so I can run the Type S axles. So now, what we're going to do, we're gonna set this back over here for now, but what we have to do, we have to press in the bearing.
I've been dancing with that.
We have to be pressing the bearing in here first.
Dada.
And then, we're gonna have to press this in into the bearing, but not to mess up. Della, I'm doing a video right now. Mm-hmm. What's up? What is it? Tell us.
I'm not telling
okay,
you.
Then tell us all. What's going on?
No, I'm only gonna tell you, not them.
Okay, tell me. Oh, orale! Oh, orale! That's unnecessary. Please move with that. Not cool. Spray me with the stuff, dude. Come on.
It's so good.
Okay, not over here. You know, I already got bad allergies, bro. Step away from me, woman. You see what I'm doing? So, when you press the bearing inside here, use this as a chase. You see what I'm saying? So that way you don't ruin the bearing. You want to press the bearing inside from the outsides. You know, so what I'm going to press the bearing, you see that? Now, this is the new bearing, right? And I'm going to use this one as a chase. See that? And it's gonna press right against it right there, all the way down, all the way to the bottom. You see what I'm saying? And then, once you do that, you gotta hold the bottom of the bearing and press the hub in, otherwise you're gonna damage it. You see what I'm saying? So, that way you can put the Chigaletta safety pin right here, the C-clamp. So that's why you gotta press the bearing in first. So I'll show you here in a second. What we got going on here, we got the new bearing and I got the old bearing. You never want to press the new bearing from the center. Like, let's say this was the new bearing and you press right here, you already ruined it. So the best way to press the old bearing in is to chase it with the old one, the new one with the old one. See that? You press it on the outside, it doesn't do any damage on the inside. And the same thing when you're gonna press the hub in, you got to be careful the same way. You want to hold the bottom in, you want to hold the bottom and then press it right inside so you don't damage it. But we gotta do the first bearing, the bearing down first, so we can put the C-clamp. So now, it is not perfectly straight. See, it's holding off right here, and then at the bottom of the bodge right there. And it's a little bit crooked, but once it starts going straight, this will just automatically will go straight, you know? So let's go ahead and just see. It's kind of moving a little bit right here. See that? Let me loosen this up a little bit so I can readjust it. See what I did? I put this little piece of pipe to kind of hold this sort of straight. It's a little bit tilted to the right, but right now it's going straight. You see that? Look at that bearing, it just slides in there like butter. You see that? think it's maxed up. I'm gonna have to raise this back up and do it all over again. And yeah, it's pretty much in right there. You got the front, got the C-clamp. So now it's very important that you hold the back of the bearing so you don't damage it. You don't wanna press straight into that. Like, you don't wanna take this and set it over there and start pressing the hub inside. So what you wanna do is you wanna put some kind of support. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna go ahead and chase this right here. See that? You see that? So that way when we press the, let me go ahead and just show you what I'm talking about here real quick. You see that? I'm gonna go ahead and set this in the center right here. And it's gonna sit right in the middle of the bearing. And then you take the hub, which the hub is right here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of crank it down just a little bit so I can show you what I'm talking about. Go way down. Okay, so you see what I did right here? I have a chase right there in the middle. So when I press this down, it's on that chase. It's not actually on the bearing itself. See, this is loose at all times. And you press in the hub into the bearing. That way you don't damage it. Now, if you were just pressing this right into this without having any support, see that? If you were gonna have no support at the bottom, you would have damaged the bearing. You see what I'm saying? So that's what you want to do. You want to support the bottom of the bearing and then press it down. And it's going to go all the way. Then you're not going to feel it. It's not going anymore. You want to go until it doesn't go anymore, until it stops. This is it. That's it. So let's see right here. Yeah, nice and smooth. Now you see that? You go up and down with it, there's no play in the bearing. See that? Remember the play they had right here? You can loosen it up a little bit too. So that way you can just put barely any pressure. So that way you can hold it. See that? Oh, hold on. Let me make it tight so it doesn't move. See? Oh, it's still moving. Okay, now it's not moving. Ay, ay, ay. Oh, it went inside the bearing. Okay, anyways, you get the point. Go ahead and take this off. And that's all to it. That is all to it. You should be having no more play right now. Look at that. Nice and smooth, brand new bearing. And you can do the side to side, and it's all done right. You see that? Now all we gotta do is just put it back on the car, assemble everything back in, it's good to go. Next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna change the oil. Since we got it up on the lift, look at that. Look at this thing, it's dry, dude. I mean, it's dirty because I drive it, but look at this thing. Dry. There's not one drop of oil on here, Della. There's not one drop of oil.
Not one drop of oil.
Right?
Right. Do you have two more batteries of this kind?
Not over here, I don't think I do. Huh? Well, anyways, guys, this kind of includes our video of how to install a wheel bearing. And I know I'm kind of all over the place. I know this whole coronavirus got everybody tripping out. You know, it's crazy out there. I know that the virus is out there, and it's proven that, you know, a cold or pneumonia kills way more people than this virus, but people still intend to trip out, you know. I understand the government is trying to hold everybody home so that way it doesn't spread and not a lot of people die, but please, people, don't freak out. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of what I got going on today. Just detail, clean it, put that wood bearing back in, and just kind of go on my day. Guys, make sure you subscribe to our channel if you like what we do here. Give us a thumbs up, share our videos, and also don't forget to press that bell to give you a warning when we upload a new video. I haven't really uploaded much lately due to this so much chaos going on, but that's kind of what I got going on today. I got wood bearings and stuff, you know, everywhere. So if you're gonna do a wood bearing swap, you know, don't worry about like having a wood bearing already there, because when you take the old one off, what I use, I have this big socket right here and a 1-inch socket set, and I kind of use all these big socket sets, whatever size I need, to kind of press in everything. So I don't even have to rent a like a press kit or anything like that. I use these sockets I have, you know, and it works out great for me, you know what I mean? So anyways, that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up, put it back in there, go on my day. Wish you guys nothing but the best. Stay safe, wash your hands, and I catch you guys next time. Don't forget, you're awesome. Much love, guys. Della, where you at? She's over here, always dancing, but she's hiding this time. She's not here, she's hiding. Well, I forgot to show you how it's fixed now. Side to side, nothing. Let's go to the other side. This is good. We're gonna take the wheel off and paint this black on the inside a little bit, because we don't have a center cap yet. I don't feel like spending $200 on center caps right now, when I just spent a fortune to get this beast right here. And I got this one for sale, because I don't need to have another beast, you know? So, anyways, that's that. It's fixed. Ready for beast mode. Gotta keep Monika ready to go every time, every time. I don't want to worry about anything. Ready to go. Cuckoo! 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 Oh, I tell you what, she's a beast, bro. She's a beast, bro.